Are you aware that oral bestiality is legal in Canada?
What's your top three favorite primary colors?
Is this what you want?
Yucky! You want to see something grosser?
Oh. So what are they doing in that toilet? Sharing Pokemon cards?
Carson King, better known as CallMeCarson, is one of the biggest up-and-coming YouTubers and Twitch streamers in recent years. And at only 21 years old, provides content in a way that many other content creators just can't figure out. His young age and unique personality make for a channel that is extremely polarizing. But Carson has been making content for so long that he has found a niche in a way that has led to massive growth over the last 2 years. Carson's early attempts at YouTube growth started when he was only 12 years old in September of 2011 on a channel called Blue Creepers 1. This channel, as you can probably tell from the name, was focused almost entirely on Minecraft content, and as expected from videos created by a 12-year-old, didn't receive much attention. There was a sign of the talent Carson had from a young age, however, as the trailers created for this channel showed the beginnings of his ability to edit and create videos, and his talents only got better as he continued creating content. The last video on Blue Creepers 1 was released in November of 2011, just 2 months later. Carson would return to YouTube and create a channel called the Blue Crew Pros, which would later come to be known as the Call Me Carson channel we all know today in mid-2014. This channel's early videos consisted of a lot of different kinds of content, from Carson's Ice Bucket Challenge video, to funny gaming moments, to parody videos, and everything in between. Carson's sense of humor began to develop into what we see in his modern videos during this time frame, with frequent bits, callbacks, and seemingly random interactions with his friends leading to hilarity, but not quite the growth that he would have hoped for. In fact, it took almost 3 years for Carson to hit 6,000 subscribers in June of 2017, despite creating high-effort content and collaborating with larger YouTubers like iNotorious and Raccoon Eggs. Carson didn't let the slow growth discourage him, however, and continued putting out content before he found the style of videos that began to make him blow up. Carson's first video that really spurred his growth was called DeviantArt is Not Safe, and it released in May of 2018 to quickly become the most watched video on his channel. It has since been surpassed by other videos in view count, but DeviantArt is Not Safe showed Carson a new kind of content that people were interested in. This style of video consists of Carson and his friends jumping into a Discord call and just sharing images they find on the internet and commentating over it to make each other laugh. So far, they've created these videos for DeviantArt submissions, yearbook quotes, Pornhub comments, pictures of food, tattoos, and even specifically toilets, and each of them went over incredibly well with Carson's YouTube audience. This increased popularity motivated Carson to begin streaming on Twitch more and more, leading him to create his alternate channel, CallMeCarson Live, and leading into a new era for Carson where he participated in a very important Minecraft server. Now, it may seem a bit strange to call a Minecraft server important, but when Carson started the SMPLive server in March of 2019, things began to change not only for Carson, but also for the friends he created content with. SMPLive is short for Survival Multiplayer Live, and it quickly became a popular source of content for everyone who played on it. The rules were, anyone playing on the server must be live streaming while they played on it, and viewers could donate to the streamer to put a hit on other players on the server, where the streamer must either kill or prank the target to fulfill the hit. The original members were Carson, Travis, Jay Schlatt, C-Scoop, Alltrive, Sneeg Snag, Joko, Mason, JC the Caster, Tumed, Poke, and Ant Venom. But the server quickly grew to have over 100 players, all of whom streamed every moment they were on the server. Every member created hours of content from this server, and Carson was no exception, growing the community they had on SMP Live and sharing viewers between each member to help each other's channels get bigger and bigger. The pranks, builds, and funny moments served to help everyone who played on SMP Live be recognized, and eventually, Carson and some of his friends were big enough to be recognized by a man named Keemstar.
What is up, Drum Alert Nation? I'm your host, Killer Keemstar. Let's get right into the news!
Some months after the SMP Live server was created, a large YouTuber named Keemstar decided to host a weekly Minecraft competition known as Minecraft Monday, where he invited some of the biggest names in gaming, Minecraft or otherwise, to participate in a set of challenges with large cash prizes. Many of the streamers from SMP Live were invited to participate, and this only served to increase their notoriety even more. And whether they won or lost, Minecraft Mondays created growth for all of its participants. Call Me Carson Live became Carson's focus for gaming content during this time, while his main channel was reserved for more focused content and IRL videos. Uploads slowed down on his main channel due to Carson's participation in a group now known as the Lunch Club, with the people he met during this time focusing on Minecraft. The Lunch Club, formerly known as Goop and Fart Club, consists of CallMeCarson, Slimesicle, Jay Schlatt, Travis, Ted Nivison, C-Scoop, and Hugbox. Some of these names should sound familiar from either SMP Live or previous interactions, and in August of 2019, the group officially came together and moved to San Diego together, where they began doing frequent collaborations. The group created the Lunch Club podcast and created videos interacting with each other in person, visiting other YouTubers, or coming up with hilarious bits to perform together, like diagnosing fake illnesses.
Let's see what's wrong with you today.
Oh, well,
What's wrong with you? Tell me.
I'm gay.
And a zoo scavenger hunt. This coming together of huge names in the gaming YouTuber sphere had created a lot of hype around the Lunch Club, despite how it isn't the normal kind of content any of them would create on their own. Much in the same way Minecraft Mondays benefited all of its participants, the Lunch Club serves a function of collaborations creating growth for all of its members. Carson, though, has remained the biggest YouTuber out of all of them, but how big has he really gotten? Now, Carson's growth is a tricky subject, because it has been so affected by the projects he has participated in. His YouTube and Twitch growth are almost entirely separate, with his Twitch channel receiving a small bump after his DeviantArt Is Not Safe video was released, and really beginning to explode once SMP Live was created. His growth has been relatively consistent on Twitch since then, averaging between 60 and 80,000 new followers each month, with a brief drop in growth in March of 2020, caused by a break to assist Carson in maintaining his mental health, followed by a controversy where Carson's girlfriend cheated on him with one of the creators he collaborated with. Carson returned to content creation just a month later and seems to be doing much better now. Carson's YouTube growth, on the other hand, began on his main channel as soon as his DeviantArt video was released, and Call Me Carson Live began growing at a much faster pace as soon as SMP Live content started coming out. His main channel went from 10,000 subscribers to 200,000 in just 3 months, and the new style of content helped him reach 1 million subscribers in under a year, then 2 million subscribers 6 months later. As Carson began to get more involved with collaborations and his own uploads slowed down, his growth slowed alongside them. But he was still able to hit 3 million subs in August of 2020, which is where he stands today. Call Me Carson Live, on the other hand, has only been around for a year and a half, and was able to hit 1 million subscribers in just 8 months, and is currently sitting at just over 1.5 million subscribers, which is much faster growth than his main channel ever experienced. Carson will sometimes receive criticism for using a lot of Zoomer humor, but his content gets results, and his videos have always been entertaining. He plays off others well, and his sarcasm and willingness to collaborate and try new types of videos is incredibly refreshing. Go give Call Me Carson a look, and you'll see his growth is deserved, and his appeal is far more widespread than everyone gives it credit for. With that though, thank you guys for watching, and I will catch you later.